Skål. Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Today I'm in the Black Forest, but a new place I've never been in before, a new area of this amazing forest. So I find a good little spot here to set up my tarp, you can see. And I had a little problems, or I wanted it to be straight here in the front. So I actually incorporated a ridge line there too. And now it's working nicely. Perfect, yeah. And you saw my new hat, my Viking hat. Do you like it? Well, I think it's cool. It's actually the old hat that I had on one of my videos a couple of times ago, and I bought recently. And I didn't like the look of that, so I changed it. I had a bit of fur down. I had a bit of fur home. That I applied to this hat, and now I think it suits me very nicely. I'm not sure what this is. It's a piece of fur I've had for a very long time. Maybe it's a fox, I don't know. But it's extremely warm, so that's why I'm not wearing it now, because well, actually the spring is near. It's about 11 degrees Celsius, so last time I was out in the forest it was minus degrees, but now, well, it's plus. So that's nice. I think the spring is just around the corner. And beside that, you saw I got a new axe. Yeah, and it's an axe from WA Blacksmith and Leathers. It's really cool, and yeah, I'll show you in detail in a minute the carving he's done on this. And I'm bringing it today because I want to test it out. I'm going to make a tripod for my coffee, my cauldron, and beside that I have a special thing I would like to show you, so hang on. Yeah, and that special thing I would like to show you is my new lantern. Yeah, I think it's pretty cool. I like the design, and again I tried to make a lantern that was easy to make, and this is in a conical shape. And I made a video about this, of course, and I put that in the end of this video. But it's very, well, it's firm here, I can't remove this, but in the bottom here, I made this. Can you see this? Just something I can put my candle in, and put it in here, and just turn it. And then it stays in place. Pretty cool, I think. So, and a little Thor hammer, Mjolnir here at the top. I'm not sure that it's going to be there, but yeah. Until now, until I find something better, I'll put it there. So let's light it up. It's not dark in here, so I'm not sure you can see the light, but let's try it. Here we go. But before I'm making my coffee, I would like to drink my mead. I actually bought some real Viking mead and mead, as we call it in Denmark. I would like to sit here and enjoy that with a little pipe, you know. Mm. It's very good. It's 20% alcohol, so it's very strong. And I put it in this bottle, and people say that you can't use these bottles with beeswax in, because the alcohol will will make it disappear. So I'm trying it and see if it's possible. Ah, and then my little clay pipe. Some tobacco. And if you see this, a forge hammer I bought from Grimfrost, put it on here. It's very nice because then the flap here is always down, and I like this design. It's very heavy and very large, and actually not so expensive. On my website I have links for this as the rest of my gear. So, where is the tobacco? Down here somewhere? Yeah. Yeah, and it's blowing a bit. And again, school everyone. And last time I made this setup with the tripod, some were asking how I did it, how I could adjust the pot here. So I'll show you that now. You have a cordage here that I attached to the top of the tripod, and then you just have a loop here, and it's actually very easy. Come the loop in and the cordage. Like this behind, perhaps it's easier like this.
Yeah,
and then I can put it up like this. Yeah, and put it down. It's a little more difficult with a natural cordage because it's not so smooth. If you use paracord, it's much better for that. But this is how it's going up. And down. Pretty cool. Yeah, and since I began this Viking adventure, I only used amadou for making my fire. But then I thought, well, char cloth, I usually do that, make that of cotton, but why not make it out of linen fabric? So I actually made some char cloth from linen, and I tried it once and it actually functioned very well. You can see here it looks exactly like the cotton. And then let's see. Yeah, I think I'll bring you a little bit away so you can see my fire making here. And as I said before, I'd like you to show you the details of this awesome axe from WA Blacksmith and Leather. Look at this. Nice carving indeed. He's very talented. Yeah. And here you can see his logo. He's from Pakistan. I got a knife from him, and I can definitely recommend you to go into his Instagram page and look at all the cool stuff he's making. He's an artist. Yeah. Really cool Viking axe, this one. And it's also very sharp and good in chopping wood. I tried that. So, yeah. But now it's almost time for coffee. Just a simple meal today, some dry meats, some breads, and some cheese here. Nothing hot today, but this is enough so I can go on after I had my little break here. This is actually dry elk meat. Tasty, very tasty. And you maybe wonder what this is. It's a new thing. I bought a bag, water bag from Sawyer. I have a Sawyer Mini, 6 ounce, 2 liters. And I just made a leather pouch for it. And then I have 2 liters of water with me. And it doesn't take much room. It can lay in my little basket I made. I think it's cool. Yeah. Well, folks, this is all for now. Thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care. And as I did with the other twos, I bought some chewing bones from dogs and let them soak in water for about 10 to 12 hours. And then I had a pot, flower pot. I would use some as a template, as a form. I'll show you here how I made my templates. Just put a piece of paper or
cardboard around it, secure it with tape, and then you decide how big you want your screen to be. I use this wooden block so that the size will be equal all the way around. Just make two. Like this. Yeah. And then I make one of these to make it a straight line. This is very important. Yeah, and then you have it. Then just take it off and cut it out with a scissor. And the reason why I used a conical form shape was because the bottle, I couldn't get it off. So I thought, well, conical shape, I can always remove it without any problems there. This way. Just be careful. And when you're finished, you can remove the extra paper you have. You don't going to need that. And then you have to, first you have to check, of course, check again. And I chose to make it in three sections. So I had to find a way I could divide this template up in three sections. First I measure it, and then, again, very important to do it right. And then I find out what is 3 and just marked it 3 times. On both sides. And then I divided it first with the ball pen. You can see, and I number it 1, 2, and 3, so I know how it's going to be assembled. And after that, I transfer it to the raw height. And here I have the 3 pieces I cut out and marked where the stitching is going to be. Just like in my other videos. And after stitching it, the 3 sides together, of course I have to sew the last part so it's going to be round. And again, I use cross stitching. I think that looks nice. And then, took the pot again, see if it fits, And then I let it dry there. And a reason why I use this conical pot is because then it won't be stuck. During the drying process, I did this a couple of times so that it got stuck on the templates or the pots. And when it was dry, I measure it around at the bottom and actually also at the top. I'm going to make my stand for it. Now you can see it's dry, but again, it doesn't keep the shape. So I had to make 2 rings, one at the top and one at the bottom. And that was not a part of my plan, but I had to do that. Here you can see they are glued in and colored with my leather dye, and then I made a platform for it. Yeah. And here you can see the platform is finished. And I have three holes for the sticks and this arrangement so I can put the candle in here. Yeah. And just secure it down here, like I showed in my video. And then I just had to get my sticks, my branches from willow, and adjust them so they could fit down in the holes. And I glue them onto the platform. And now I just put the treen on. Of course it fits nicely. And yeah, put them together at the top. And I used natural cordage to bind them together. Tight, of course. Yeah. And at the first I used a little, you see a little ball, a little pearl here, but I changed that for the Thor's hammer. And now I'm going to try to light it up for the first time using a candle. It's already very exciting to the first time to see how the lamp, the lantern is performing. Up there, yeah. There you are, my little lantern. I think it's a very nice little lantern. I love it very much. It's very primitive and old school. Here you can see, yeah, a little bit dark, and compare it to the other one I made, the second one. I think they are very cozy to look at and easy to transport when I'm out making my Viking hikes.